In elementary school, we all learn how to tell time on a clock, but have you ever learned how to tell time using the sun, especially how rare it is to
come
out?
When we get some, that's the key here. Candace Monticelli has another experiment to teach us how to do just that. Hey, Candace.
Good morning. We will get plenty of sunny days ahead. We always do in West Michigan. And of course, we love enjoying the four seasons. But today, we are going to learn how the sun can actually help us tell time. So we're going to make a sundial. Here's a list of what you need to get started. First, a paper plate, a marker, a pencil, and a ruler. So what you want to do is you want to start with the back of your paper plate. And in my case, I have tape measure, but take your ruler and just draw four lines splitting the paper in fourths. Then mark your numbers accordingly around the clock and punch a hole in the center of the plate. Take your pencil, push it through that hole. And now when we have a fully sunny day, take this outside and place it somewhere in the yard, away from any trees, any fences, anything like that. You don't want to have any shadows on this plate. You want it to get full direct sunlight. The key here is to 12 noon, where you have that number 12 on your plate, you want that to be facing north. This then will give you the accurate time all the way throughout the day, because it's all dependent on where that shadow of the pencil falls on the plate for what number the time is during the day. So we just simply created a sundial. Really cool, really easy. And this is actually how people way back in the day told the hours and minutes during the day, just like how we use a clock. So what's going on is the Earth revolves around the sun. We see the sun rise in the east and set in the west. That motion, that movement of the sun, that allows a different shadow to be cast from the pencil onto the plate at all different times throughout the day. So once you put that 12 noon facing north, that's when that shadow will then follow around the clock for the correct time. And it'll be pretty darn accurate. So every sundial has two basic parts. You have your pointer, which is called your style or your gnomon. And then you have the bottom base, which reflects the shadow on to the dials of where the numbers are. And that then will, of course, tell you what time it is. So there you have it. We created a sundial. Now we just have to wait for a sunny day to actually use it. But a really simple tool to make at home today with the kids. So if you try this out, send me your pictures on Facebook. I'd love to see those. And of course, there's a full list of instructions on Fox17Online.com.